Katie and Alice, the children. This is a presentation on the two family lines, Hollins and Franklin. And now we're going to take a look at Katie's children and Alice's children. This is a chart that was generated through the MyHeritage website, and it shows three generations from John and Betsy Williams. Katie had five kids: Alice, Bertha, Dora, Daisy, and Henry. Alice had six kids: Ethel, Alzati, Katie, Mary, Bessie, and the baby Louise. You notice that each sister named one of their children, one of their girls, after them. Katie named Alice after her sister Alice, and Alice named Katie, her daughter, after her sister Katie. Katie Williams married Monroe Hollins when they were 31 and 21 years old. He was 31 and she was 21. From that marriage came Alice, Bertha, Dora, Daisy, and Henry, the baby. Okay, this is the 1920 census in the state of Louisiana in the Rapides Parish and city of Pineville. This is Katie's family on the 1920 census. And the part that's in parentheses is the household. And as you can see, this is a very different situation. Flora Smith is the head of this household. Then you see Monroe Hollins. It says son-in-law because he was her son-in-law. He was married to her daughter and she passed away. And then he married Katie and they moved in with Flora because that is where he was living. I think maybe from looking at the census, and I'm going to show you why I came up with the reason for this. And it looks like Flora knew Katie from working together and knew that Monroe needed another wife. And I think she loved her very much and wanted someone nice for him. Because back then, again, the way of life was marriage. Okay, and as you can see there, Eva is right under Katie's name. You see Katie Williams. Eva was the daughter that Monroe had before he met Katie with his wife who passed away. And Alice is their firstborn, Katie and Monroe. You see her under Eva, which she's 2 years and 4 months. And then you see Bertha right under there, and she's not even a year old. Looks like that's about 5 months. The 1920 census was very different from that 1870 census that we talked about in part one, where they were concerned with the constitutional relations and whether a person was deaf and dumb or insane. Those blocks are no longer on the census. Now they seem to be concerned with immigration. They wanted to know the place of birth and the of the person, their mother and their father, and each of their mother's tongue, for the father, for the mother, and then for the person. I guess they figured out it was no reason to count that, and voting, again, that probably wasn't accurate at all. So anyway, now we're looking at their occupation, and the arrows are indicating the occupation for Florida. The one on the top is a laundress, and the one on the bottom, the second arrow, is Katie's. She was a laundress, and they both work at home. Now, that W on the column after at home means wage. On Katie's, OA means on her own account. So Katie was actually working for either Flora, or she was helping her, or whatever, because she wasn't receiving a wage. The one above it, that where there's no arrow, that's Monroe's occupation, where it shows that he's a laborer, and that's in construction. On the left-hand side of the census, you see where they have stuff that's transcribed or typed. And you see that Flora Smith, who was the head of this household, was a female, and she was 58 years old and a widow. The son-in-law, he kind of got the relationship mixed up, but I guess she's just still called Monroe her son-in-law. He was 34, and he's married, of course, to Katie. And you see her name right under his, Katie Williams Hollins, and she's 24, so they were really young. Katie was really young, just starting off. The granddaughter, which is Monroe's daughter, was 15, and Katie's two daughters that she had with Monroe were 2 and 4 months, which is Alice, and 5 months old, Grandmama, or Bertha. On the next census, the 1930 census in the state of Louisiana, Rapides Parish in Pineville, the whole family is there now. You see, and they're in their own house, but it looked like they're living right next door to Flora Smith and Eva. The names are spelled incorrectly, so it was hard to find this. My dad helped me locate this one. I had a hard time finding their 1930 census, but we found it. Like I said, the census takers, a lot of times they weren't that accurate, so piecing stuff together, names spelled incorrectly, it's kind of hard sometimes, but we found them. So first we have the head of household, which is Monroe, and that little R that's right by the head means he's renting. And look at how much that rent is, $8 a month. Can you believe that? Well, back then, $8 was a whole bunch of money. If you look at the next line, Katie, that's his wife. So we know these are the right people. You have Alice right under there. And at this time, she is 12. Bertha is 9. Dora is 6. Daisy is 5. And Henry is 3. And I think they have Katie's years wrong, because she was 24 10 years ago. That looked like that's 26. Oh, I don't know about that. Anyway, they either wrote her down wrong, or Mama Kate told him a little lie. Just kidding. Okay, you can look right up above and you see, let's take a look at Flora's household. So you see Flora, and she's head of household. That O right next to head is own. She owns her home, and that $750 is how much it costs. Wow. Today is terrible. You can't even find a house probably for less than $300,000 anywhere. So you can see the real, real big difference in today and then in 1930. Can you see Eva Hollins? That's Monroe's daughter. And he is a grandpa because Ophelia is Eva's daughter. And my mother told me that Eva died early too, so I don't know if it was something genetic or whatever, but she died early just like her mother did, which was Monroe's first wife. Monroe's occupation on this census was still laborer, but if you look at the construction part, it have highway printed right above it. So he worked for the highway department in construction. Okay, right under his name is Katie's occupation, and she's still a laundress, but if you look, she works in a private family home, and she is a wage earner now. She earns a wage, so she's actually getting paid. Eva also works as a cook in a private family, so I don't know if that's the same family or not, but Katie was still a laundress. After looking at both censuses, I wanted to touch on some things about Monroe and Katie Hollins. Okay, Monroe Hollins. Okay, he married Katie Williams in 1917. He was born in Louisiana in 1885, according to the census. He worked as a laborer for the highway department as a construction worker. He was previously married and had one child from that marriage named Eva Hollins when his first wife passed away. Flora Smith was his mother-in-law from that union. On the 1920 census, he is still living in his mother-in-law's house on Main Street in Pineville, Louisiana, when he married Katie and moved her into the mother-in-law's house. He could read and write, according to the 1920 census. His granddaughter, June Williams Riley, relayed to me that after he retired, he used to sit on the porch in a tall chair and watch the construction of the freeway that was being built right across the street from his house located on Asylum Road in Pineville, Louisiana. She stated that during his career as a construction man for the Department of Highway, he once fell off a roof and hurt his back. He would round up all of his grandchildren so they can walk on his back to help relieve the pain. Katie Hollins. According to the 1920 census, Katie was a laundress who worked from home along with Flora. I am guessing they did laundry for people out of the house. On the 1930 census, they both were laundress, but during this time, they worked in someone else's home. She could read and write, according to the 1920 census. Another note is Flora ended up retiring because she was 66 on the 1930 census. Okay. Katie and Monroe had 5 children together and 6 counting Eva Hollins from his first marriage. On the 1930 census, the family is no longer living in Flora's house. They moved right next door where one can see Flora, Eva, and Ophelia, Eva's daughter, who are left in the mother-in-law's household. Okay, these are Monroe and Katie Holland's children, the oldest three. You have on the top right, Alice Davis. And in the middle, coming down, is Bertha Riley. And at the bottom is Dora Douglas. The Monroe and Katie Holland's children, the youngest two. The one at the top is Daisy Gustav. And the one at the bottom is the baby, Henry Hollins. Okay, Alice Williams married David Franklin when they were 23 and 20 years old. From this marriage came Ethel, Alzady, Katie, Mary, Bessie, and Louise. On the 1920 census in the state of Louisiana, in East Baton Rouge, they started off and their first house, I guess, was rented. Now, Dave Franklin, they have him down instead of David, but Dave Franklin is the head of household. And he is 23 on here. And Alice, his wife, is 20. Now, his daughter, Alzati, is on here. And Pearl. Now, this kind of confused me because I think Ethel is the oldest and I don't see her anywhere. And then Pearly popped up. And I was first thinking that Alice had a baby before she met Dave, which would have made her be like 13 years old having a baby. And I didn't figure it out until after the 1930 census, in which we will look at. Pearl is not in there, so I was looking for Pearl. I thought maybe she died or something. And then come to find out, Pearl is her sister and Katie's sister. That's John Williams, their father's daughter with Miss Patsy. And that's not the only one. They had a whole bunch of them. So Pearlie probably was visiting Alice on this day, and the census people counted her as part of that household. So I don't know what happened there and why the census taker counted her, but they did. Another thing I noticed, just to show you how inconsistent these census takers were, they have the race down as black, and on the other one in Pineville, they had the race down as Negro. Just something to look at. Okay, and Alzady is only 6 months old on the 1920 census, and Pearly is 7, hanging around her big sister. Okay, on this census, the occupation for Dave is a farmer. And they've had it listed as general, so I guess not a certain, like, onion farm or tomato farm or something. I guess general meaning a whole bunch of stuff. Okay, under Dave's occupation as a farmer, you see Alice's occupation, which is none, which means that she was a homemaker who worked in the house. At that time, that was normal. Most women worked in the house. I know Katie had a job, but that's about all they did was work in people's houses if they did work. And now, on the 1930 United States federal census, they got David Franklin down as Dane Franklin. I don't know, D-A-N-E. But I know this is the right one because look at all those names. By this time, their whole family is there. Everybody's here. The baby Luis is there. So in his household is him. And I think they wrote it down as Dave, but these other people transcribed that into Dane. It looked like a Dave. It's just a handwriting, just probably hard for people to read. He's the head of household. That O right next to his name means that he owned his own home. And look at how much it is. $100. Wow. That is something else when you look at it that way. He did pretty well. It looks like he owned his own home, and that home was also on a farm, and he was a farmer. So his wife didn't have to work. It looks like they did really well. Okay, and then Alice, the wife, see her under there. She's now 29. And now they have his age is 30. Oh well. There's Ethel. Now, I don't know where she was on the 1920 census. Maybe she was visiting, like Pearlie was visiting Alice's household. But there she is. Alzada. Alzate. They got Alzada on there, but it's Alzady. And she is 8 years old. You got Katie, is named after Alice's sister, 7 years old. And you have Mary, who's six. Bessie, who's four. And Louise, who's three. Now, on this one, now they have Negro. So I don't know. I guess people changed. Instead of calling, black people black, they started calling them Negroes or on these different forms. Yeah, you can't see it on here, but when I scrolled up, there's a bunch of Williams up there. So it looked like there's a bunch of family living close by, that right down the street, like Katie's family. A lot of people live right down the street from each other. And I saw Pearlie up there in another household. But she's actually married, though, by this time. She's a wife in there, so she's not listed in John Williams' household and Patsy. Okay, on this part of the 1930 census, it shows the occupation again, and David is a farmer and a general farmer again. That's what they have listed there. Okay, after looking at the 1920 and 1930 census, I came up with a few things that I noticed. Okay, that they were married in about 1915. He was born in Louisiana, David Franklin, in 1897. He was a farmer and owned his own house, which is located on the farm where he worked. He had six girls with Alice, but at first, like I said before, I thought it was seven counting Pearlie. Sorry, I misspelled her name. Typo. But that's Pearlie. Okay, but I found out through more research that she was Alice's and Katie's sister from their dad, John and Patsy Williams. Okay, David's name on the 1930 census was spelled incorrectly. They spelled it Dane instead of Dave, but I was able to determine the mistake. Since Alice and the rest of their girls were listed with him in the same town, he could read and he could write. And for Alice Franklin, Alice was a homemaker. I'm quite sure she helped on the farm, but her main job was taking care of their six girls. Back in those days, most women did not work outside of the home. Marriage was a way of life. The man worked outside of the home and the woman took care of the kids and the home. When a woman lost a husband, she had to find another one so that she and her kids would be able to survive. A man would get another wife once he lost one too, for the same reason, but with the roles reversed. Now, some of the elders on the Franklin side may be able to clear up some more things or verify whatever I've speculated on, but I'm pretty sure that I got it pretty close to it. Okay, David and Alice Franklin's children, the oldest three, the one on the left, which is the first picture we see, is Katie. Then the next picture over is Ethel. And the one at the bottom is Alzate. Okay, David and Alice Franklin's children continued. And these are the three youngest ones. The one at the top on the left is Mary. The one in the middle on the right is Louise. And the one at the bottom is Bessie. Mm-hmm.